Assalamu alaikum, dear students. I am your English teacher, Miss Farhash Shaheen. Today we will discuss month of August and September assignment. Assignment number 2, unit number 4, Golden Crab. The story taken from the Yellow Fairy Book by Andrew Long. The fairy books are a series of 25 collections of true and fiction stories for children, published by between 1889 and 1930. Andrew Long was a poet, novelist, and critic, but is the best known for those anthologies of the collection stories. Although Andrew made the most of the selections, his wives and other translators did a large portion of the translating and retelling of the action stories he collected. The Golden Crab is the Greek fairy tale that tells us the story of the fisherman. Now let's start the unit number 4, page number 33. The Golden Crab. Once upon a time, there was a fisherman who had a wife and 3 children. Every morning, he went out the fishing, and whatever fish he caught, he sold to the king. One day, among the other fishes, he caught the golden crab. When he came home, he put all the fishes together into a great dish. But he kept the crab separate because it shone so beautifully, and placed it upon a high shelf in the cupboard. Now while the old woman, his wife, was cleaning the fish, she suddenly heard a voice which said, "Hello, please get me out." She turned round in surprise, and then he saw the golden crab. What you can speak, can you? She said. Then she took him up and placed him on the table. When her husband came home, they sat down to the dinner. Presently, they heard the crab's little voice saying, "Give me some too." They were all very much surprised, but they gave him some food. When the old man came to take away the crab's dinner plate, he found it full of gold. As the same things happened every day, he soon became rich. Golden Crab is the Greek fairy tale that tells us the story of the fisherman who one day catches the golden crab together with fish. The crab is being taken to the fisherman's house, where he demands to be fed. So the fisherman and his wife feed the creature, but he demanded to marry the king's young daughter. Page number 34. Very fond of the crab, one day the crab said to the fisherman's wife, "Go to the king and tell him I wish to marry his younger daughter." The old woman went to the king and told him what the crab wanted. The king laughed a little at not declining the proposal altogether. He was the prawned moorage and knew that the crab was the likely to be a prince in disguise. He said to the fisherman's wife, "Tell the crab, I will give him my daughter if by tomorrow morning he can build a wall in front of my castle, much higher than my tower, with the blooming flowers from around the world growing up on top." The fisherman's wife went home and gave this message to the crab. Then the crab gave him her a golden rod and said, Go and with this rod and three times upon the ground on the place which the king showed you, and the tomorrow morning the wall will be there." And this is true. There was a very wonderful wall. The old woman did the next morning. When the king awoke, what do you think he saw? The wall stood there before his eyes exactly as he had described it. Then the old woman went back to the king and said to him, "Your Majesty, orders have been fulfilled." "This is all very well," said the king, "but I cannot give away my daughter until there stands in front of my place a garden in which there are the three fountains, of which the first must be spray gold, and the second one diamonds, and the third one brilliants." So the old woman had to strike again three times upon the ground with the rod, and the next morning the garden was there. The king now gave him the concert, and the wedding was fixed for very next day. Then the crab said to the old fisherman, "Now take this rod, go and knock with it on the certain mountain. Then a servant will come out and ask you what you wish for. The answer him thus, 'Your master, the king, has sent me to tell you that you must send him his golden garment, and that is like the sun, making give you a beside the queenly robes of the gold and precious stones, which are like the flower and meadows, and the bring them both to me, and bring me also the golden cushion." The fisherman's wife went home, and they set the crab on the golden cushion and went to the king's place, and the marriage will be fixed for the very next day. Then the crab said to the fisherman, "Now take this rod, go and knock with it on the certain mountain. Then the black man will come out, and what you for answer him, 'Your master, the king, has sent me to tell you that you must send him his golden garment that is like the sun, make him give you beside the queenly robe and gold and the precious stones which are like the flowers and other things.'" The old man went to and his aunt when he had brought the precious robe, and the crab put on the golden garments, and then the crab upon the golden cushion. The fisherman carried him टू द कैसल वेयर द क्रैब प्रेजेंटेड द अदर गारमेंट टू हिज ब्राइड. देन द वेडिंग सेरेमनी टुक प्लेस. लेटर व्हेन द मैरिड पेयर वर अलोंग टुगेदर टुगेदर द क्रैब मेड हिमसेल्फ नॉन टू हिज यंग वाइफ. He told her that he was the son of the greatest king in the world, but he was ancient so that he became a crab by day and was a man only at night. He also explained that he could change himself into an eagle as often as he wished. Then he shook himself and immediately became a handsome youth, but the next morning he was forced to creep back again into his crab shell, and the same thing happened every day. The prince's affection of the crab and the polite attention with which he behaved to him surprised the royal family. They suspected some secrets, but though they spied it and they spied it, they could not discover it. The year passed away. The princess seemed happy, but her mother and still other whole matter very strange. At last, she said to the king that he ought to ask his daughter whether she would to have the crab. The daughter was questioned. She only answered, "I am happily married to the crab." Then the king said to her, "I will hold a tournament in your honor, and I will invite all the princes in the world to it. If any one of them places you, you shall marry him." In the evening, the princess told this to the crab, who said to her, "Take this rod, go to the garden gate, and knock with it, and the servant will come out." Every time the servant came out, "And the masters, the king has sent me here to tell you, send his golden armor and his steed." She had not been told. She ran into her daughter's room. When the crab shell was still lying, took it up and threw it into the fire. The poor princess cried bitterly, but it was no use. Her husband and didn't come back. Now we must leave the princess and turn to the other peoples in this story. One day the old man went to the stream to dip in the crust of the bread which he was going to eat, when a dog came out and the water snatched the bread from his hand and ran away. The old man ran after him, but the dog reached a door, pushed it and opened, and ran it with the old man following him. He didn't overtake the dog, but found himself above a staircase. Now the dog change into the eagle. An eagle flew to the fountain, and there was abashed themselves when suddenly they were changed into the 12 handsome youth. Now they seated themselves at the table, and one of them took up a cup and said, a health to my father," and the other said, "A health to my mother," and so the healths went around. Then the one of them said, "A health to my dearest lady, long may she live and well, but a curse on the crueler mother that burned my golden shell." And so saying, he wept bitterly. Then the youth rose from the table, went back to the great stone fountain, turned themselves into the eagle again, and they flew away. The old man went home soon after. He heard that the princess was ill, and that the only thing that
Did he could was the having the story told to her and therefore went to the royal castles. The old man tell the, all the story to the princess. The princess. He didn't overtake the dog but found himself above a staircase. Now the dog changed into the eagle. An eagle flew to the fountain and there was abashed themselves when suddenly they were changed into the 12 handsome youth. Now they seated themselves at the table and one of them took up a cup and said, a health to my father, and the other said, a health to my mother. And so the healths went around. Then the one of them said, a health to my dearest lady, long may she live and well, but a curse on the crueler mother that burned my golden shell. And so saying, he wept bitterly. Then the youth rose from the table, went back to the great stone fountain, turned themselves into the eagle again, and they flew away. The old man went home soon after. He heard that the princess was ill, and that the only thing that did he could was the having the story told to her, and therefore went to the royal castles. The old man tell the, all the story to the princess. The princess look very happy, and yes, he answered certainly. Now she says the old man, ke please bring me in the castle. The old man bring the princess in the castle, where she saw her husband amongst all the 12 eagles. He recognized her husband amongst them, and he tried to come out of her hiding place, but the old man held her back. Then the youths seat themselves at the table, and now the prince said again, when it was his turn to speak, a health to my dearest lady, long may she live and well, but a curse on the cruel mother that burned my golden shell. Then the princess could hold back to the long. She ran forward and threw her arms around her husband. She was very happy to see her. Do you remember how I told you that the day that you would betray me, he said. Now you see that I spoke truth, but all the bad times is past. Though I must still remain in handed for 3 months, will you stay here with me till that time is over? So the princess stayed with him and said to the old man, go back to the castles and tell my parents that I am staying here. Her parents were very much vexed when the old man came back and told them this. But after the 3 months of the princess enhancement were over, he ceased to be an eagle and become once more a man. They returned to home together and they lived happily ever after. The golden crab, the happiest of the prince and princess who become a family, and they live very happily. The moral of the story is the jealousy is not good thing. His mother-in-law was jealous to the prince. That's why, and the evil thing is not good. Now the students, you listen to me very carefully. My dear students, I know very well you are very good student. Being a teacher, I strongly feel that the each child is the different and unique, and this is the a time where the approach shape is given to your future. If we keep reading every day, and the last she ran forward and threw her arms around her husband. She was very happy to see her. Do you remember how I told you that the day that you would betray me? He said, now you see that the I spoke truth, but all the bad times is past, though I must still remain in handed for 3 months. Will you stay here with me till that time is over? So the princess stayed with him and said to the old man, go back to the castles and tell my parents that I am staying here. Her parents were very much vexed when the old man came back and told them this. But after the 3 months of the princess' enhancement were over, he crazed to be an eagle and become once more a man. They returned home together and they lived happily ever after. The golden crab, the happiest of the prince and princess who become a family, and they live very happily. The moral of the story is the jealousy is not a good thing. His mother-in-law was jealous to the prince, and that's why, and the evil thing is not good. Now the students, you listen to me very carefully. My dear students, I know very well you are very good student. Being a teacher, I strongly feel that the each child is the different and unique, and this is the a time where the approach shape is given to your future. If we keep reading every day, and the last we become a good reader and good writer. My dear students, success has no shortcut. So be responsible, be sincere, and be creative. And I wish that the online classes will be the brightest year of your life. Good luck. Thank you. I am missing you. I love you all. You are doing great. I will see you soon in the class. I am missing you, my dear students. Dear students, all the queries related to this story, I will discuss on WhatsApp. And I will also explain the exercise and question answers in next video. Till then, Allah Hafiz. Goodbye.